Welcome back to Center Stage. We're here with Today Show anchor Carson Daly. Total Request Live becomes, as I said, going to break, a cultural phenomenon. When you got the gig, did you think it was going to be that big? Could you dream that
big? No, not at all. When I got to MTV, I was looking for my own thing to do. Mm-hmm. And they had a show on called MTV Live, and it was just their live afternoon show. Mm-hmm. And they kind of threw me as like the correspondent on that. I was outside in the street with the kids. And then I hosted another show called Total Request that was based on the idea of these your top 10. It was a top 10 countdown show, but it was based on emails. It was kind of a futuristic vibe. And so we just thought, let's combine these two ideas, and we did. And it became Total Request Live. So the through line for the show was the top 10 videos of the day counted backwards, and then people would stop by. And I would be the only host of it. It started with just me and a couple camera guys in that studio, no audience, nobody did. Maybe there was a guy who was like, hey, I'm from the Bronx.
Right.
You know, like the one sign. And then a few months later, I'd look outside and there'd be like five people, like, I'm from Connecticut. You know, like, oh, they're really traveling now. And then eventually movie stars started to come, and TRL became a legitimate press stop for A-listers when they would do the circuit in New York. You would have to do TRL.
Did you guys look at each other and go, is this really happening?
It's crazy, yeah. No, it was insane.
Now, I would imagine that back in Philadelphia, when Dick Clark was doing Bandstand, you know, you almost become a star maker. Did you feel that you were that?
I never thought that. I see that now, looking back at what time that was in music. Bandstand was the first time that the kids could see their own peers on TV. Like, oh, look what they're wearing. And I think TRL had a lot of that sort of, it was a generation that came home from school to see what their peers looked like and what they were into. It was like high school. You had Eminem was the bad boy. You had the cheerleader and Britney Spears, Backstreet Boys and 98 Degrees. But then you also had, you know, Korn and POD and a big rock thing happening, too. So it was a really interesting time in music. And TRL, like that stage, was just the high school. We just housed it all.
Now, the research that we have indicates that you didn't just get handed TRL, that you had to go up against somebody. Is it true you went up against Ryan Seacrest?
I don't know. I don't think so. We never competed. There's always been similarities, I think, just because we're just do a lot of the same sort of types of jobs.
Mm-hmm. But we've been friends. New Year's
Eve. Yeah, yeah. New Year's Eve and radio.
Right.
And singing shows,
right.
Now with a voice.
You hate his guts?
No, not at all. I don't. No, not at all. No, God, no. Ryan's alarmingly talented at what he does.
He is
somebody that... It's like golf. Like, you look at it, you're like, I could do that. People say it all the time. Like, what discernible talent is it that you do? And I go... Don't worry, I don't know. Like, what? I never thought about it. But the truth is, to host one of those live shows in front of 15 million people in prime time, it's not easy to do. And Ryan does it better than most.
I'm wondering, with the TRL success, and just to parallel it to like a broadcaster in baseball.
Sure.
You're around guys making $20 million a year.
Yeah.
You're not.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Did you ever get caught up in the culture where you're hanging with them and you're dating them and things? I mean, did you become one of them?
I think for a short time I lost myself. It was very public. You know, I got to New York in 98. Yankees won the World Series, as you well know, in 98, 99, 2000. So it was a great time to be young in the scene in New York.
Yep.
TRL was taking off at that time. I'm single. I come from no money. Now I'm making a coin. I'm at the World Series on the field. I'm hanging with Jeter. I'm hanging with all the guys.
Right.
I'm drinking beers with the Yankees after home games. I'm going out with Jay-Z. So you get, like, you know, to the club and the dinners, and then people go to, like, Miami in the winter and St. Bart's. And there's a circuit of stupidity, really, that goes on. I know it now. And I definitely got caught up in that for a little while. I'm just really thankful for my upbringing and... Because the ship just sort of writes itself.
It could have gotten that.
Really could have,
In your life, there's been a threat, unfortunately, of cancer. You lost your dad to it, and then your mom had breast cancer.
That's right.
How does it affect the person you are right now?
It's tough. Unfortunately, I'm not alone in that being affected. All too many of us now are affected. We all know somebody.
Didn't your mom call you up before you're going on a live show?
Yeah.
I mean, what a gamer, though. She would not let
diagnosed.
You come home.
Yeah. My mom called me. And I could hear the screams of TRL in the background. And they said, there's a call for you in your dressing room. And I got it. And she told me the news. And I was like, I'm on a plane. I'm going to JFK right now. I'm out of here.
Right.
And she said, no. You go finish your show. You have a job. Go do your job. And we'll sort this out. And we're getting more information. And, you know, it might not be as bad as we. So I ended up going back to work. And I had to go and smile and, high-five people and hang with, you know, rappers and play, you know, music videos. Meanwhile, I'm thinking my mom might be dying. And by the way, if I had been a banker or a ditch digger, I would have done the same thing. I would have did what my mom said.
And she's okay now.
She is, thank God. She's great. Thank you very much.
Right.
Yeah. Thank you.
You know, in in researching the show, Carson, I'm watching a lot of stuff on YouTube from TRL.
Why? Why do you do that?
Because I want to know about
you're
you. I want to get inside
man.
Your soul. I came across a clip of Mariah Carey.
Okay.
When she brings the ice cream
oh,
out.
Oh, yeah, of course.
And a lot of people have told me, well, that was a meltdown. And I said, I don't know. I mean, she had to be in on the joke with the ice cream cart. Did she have a meltdown on live TV?
That was a meltdown, I think, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's debatable, but I think it's pretty widely accepted for anybody that saw that. Real. I was actually on Letterman the next night or the night after, and he described it well. He referred to that moment as a pop star, a diva melting down on live TV.
I mean, it was kind of weird.
It was weird. It was a weird moment, really, because Mariah, who was so prolific on MTV at that time, has a big crew, and before she would ever come, security would come through first, make sure the exits are cool. Where's Miss Carey going to stand? Right here on the X. Okay, the lighting's a little harsh. All the stories that you read were very true.
Right.
So for her to all of a sudden one day just show up unannounced, I had no idea she was there or coming, and with no team, no posse, with this idea of pushing an ice cream cart to visit us on TRL, and I don't even know what her motive was. She wasn't pushing a record or anything. Short shorts, she read a poem. I mean, she was just...
When she peeled off the Loverboy T-shirt, were you afraid what was underneath? Did you think on live TV she'd be nude or something?
I was hoping that. I still, you know, I'm still human. No, please, no bra. The subsequent story was she ended up checking herself in, I think, to a hospital the next day or...
Wow.
And stopped business. And, you know, she was overwhelmed at that time. And she thought that would be a fun moment. And I don't think her team necessarily agreed, but it ended up making for probably one of our most talked about moments.
One of our most talked about things is we do a segment on the show called Did You Ever?
Okay.
All right, you ready for this?
Oh, God.
Okay.
Sure.
Here we go.
I'm going to lie, I'm warning you.
Did you ever steal anything?
Yes, but benign things. A roll from a market. Jimmy Kimmel still thinks I'm a thief for, and I say that I thought they were free.
Were you just hungry?
I don't know what I did. It was a big bin, and there was like these little rolls, these tiny little bite-sized ones, and I just walked by and I grabbed one. Technically it's
wow.
Thievery, but I don't think I'm going to prison.
Did you ever eat an entire pizza by yourself?
Yes, I'm sure, yes.
Did you ever make a hole-in-one?
No, I've never made a hole-in-one.
Really? That must
no.
be... That must at you.
My dad has played golf his entire life all over the world. He has 3 hole-in-ones all in the same hole, the same golf course.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Did you ever try to record your own songs?
No, never. No.
Can you sing?
Not well, no. And I'm not singing for you.
Okay. Did you ever...
No chairs would turn if I sang.
Did you ever stay home and watch 60 Minutes instead of going to your high school prom?
That's a true story. God rest his soul. I always say Ed Bradley was my prom date. I stayed home, yeah.
Now, why did you do that?
I was going to play golf the next morning because I was an avid golfer. And then the whole prom thing, I didn't have a girlfriend. And my dad was like, don't worry about it. Look at the money you're going to save. all the hype and the buildup about prom. And then it ends. It's over. You know, my dad's like Regis. It's over. And sure enough, the next morning, I woke up early. I played golf with my dad. And he was like, see, prom's over. You played good, kid.
Did you ever want to punch any guest in the mouth?
Only a few. Not many. Only a few.
Did you ever walk past a mirror with all your success and wink and go, yeah, I got it going
never,
on?
Never. Never.
Never.
Never once.
Never
no.
once. Did you ever find yourself jealous of another host's talent?
Oh, sure. You look at what Jimmy Fallon's doing right now, his ability, or even my friend Jimmy Kimmel. I watch these guys. They seem like the greats.
Did you ever work with Guinness to make St. Patrick's Day an official holiday?
I did, yes.
How'd that go?
It might have been a promotion. I'm
right.
not sure. It was a real petition, however.
Mm-hmm.
But if it is official holiday, it should be.
Did you ever, during TRL, fall in love with one of your guests?
Yeah, I dated a few of them. It's out there. Listen, the smartest thing like a guy like Enrique Iglesias does
right.
is like find the hottest chick out there and call her agent and say, do you want to be in a music video? Because then you get to meet all these attractive
right.
women.
Right.
I had a lot of them coming on. I'd be like, hey, this girl's really good. We should get her on TRL. That show's going to be a big show. And then you get a chance to meet them. So it was a good place to meet
girls.
It's
a great gig. Like that.
It
yeah.
was a good gig. Yeah,
yeah. Smart.
It was smart.
But then
smart.
It goes to late night TV. How did that happen? We'll find out when we come back on Center Stage.